Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da, habati fillah. This is the last sitting, our manhajiyya. And I wanted to mention one other hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and some important points about this that we didn't necessarily cover in the other sittings. And this is the fact that the reality is the ummah would split. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to be one and that we should not divide. We're supposed to be unified. Muslims are supposed to be one hand. Everybody realizes the importance of being a single unity, and everybody's blaming others, each other, for splitting. But in fact, the unity has to be based on substance. It has to be based on the Quran and the Sunnah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabil kareem, wa tasmu bi hablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu. Adhere all of you steadfast to the rope of Allah and do not divide. Okay, rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some of the mufassireen, the people of tafsir, they explain that that is the Quran. And some of them say it's broader than that, you know, it's the Quran and the Sunnah and the Jama'ah and so on and so forth. So we know we need to divide, we need to split, we need to be one, but it's on, it has, what did he say? Allah commanded it. Wa'tasimu bihablillah. Hold on to the rope of Allah. He didn't say hold on to just unifying on political matters. He didn't say wa'tasimu bi habli siyasa. He didn't say hold on to the hand of politics. He didn't say hold on to the hand of qomiya, nationalism. He didn't say hold on to the minhaj of the ecological forest. He didn't say that. But he said wa'tasimu bi habli llahi jami'an. So that means our unity can only be by the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showing us that it's sinful to split, but it's just the reality. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesied that, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions all the nations before us. Hatta ta'tihum al-bayna, you know, that's when they begin splitting and dividing. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, iftarqat al-yahud ala 72 firqa, wa iftarqat al-nasara ala 72 firqa, wa sataftariku hadhihi umma ala 73 firqa kullaha fi an-nar al-wahida. كنا من هي يا رسول الله قال من كان على مثل ما كان عليه وصحابي اليوم. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the Jews were breaking into 71 sects, Christians into 72 sects, my nation into 73 sects, all of them in the fire except one. He said, who are they, ya Rasulullah? He said, those who are upon what I'm upon and my companions are upon today. So it shows us that we would split, we would divide, we would be in the wrong, and that the only unity can come based on the book and the Sunnah, and following the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, and that's the madhab of the salaf. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal, the Almighty, to put barakah in what we say and forgive us of our many sins and our many shortcomings and our mistakes. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah Azza wa Jal. Anything that said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ilm and nafir, uskan tayyib wa amal mutaqabbin, wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And thus ends our majalisa minhajiyya mountainiyya. Our mountain-based sittings of Minhaj. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.